with another episode of Amos Fucking E.
This, Brett from Muhammad's God-given anus, Scavage from the Holy Land, Lord Viandal's first of his name, aye, Sadie Humble Meccans, stone to the fires and rape women in the ass, ha-snorting toenails, flying monkey socks, well-a-vi, ser el hombre la sera, ay-galambra, veranita na nocho. I am fucking stone. Where the fuck is the police? I love you! Islam teaches good morals, sexism, but those wives from whom you fear arrogance, first advise them, then if they persist, forsake them in bed, and finally, strike them. Men are the maintainers of women because Allah has made some of them to excel others and because they spend out of their property. And call unto witness from among your men two witnesses, but if there are not two men, then one man and two women. The male shall have the equal of the portion of two females, slavery and rape. O prophet, we have made lawful to thee thy wives to whom thou hast paid their dowers, and those slaves whom thy right hand possesses out of the prisoners of war whom Allah has assigned to thee. Abstain from sex, except of those joined to them whom their right hand possesses. Child fucking. As for those of your women who have despaired of menstruation, if you have a doubt, their prescribed time shall be 3 months, and of those too who have not had their courses. Polygamy. If ye fear that ye shall not be able to deal justly with the orphans, marry women of your choice, two or three or four. You know, technically, I'd be way more accepting of Allah compared to normal Muslims. I'm totally alright with fucking several wives and fucking children. Really, I am. As proclaimed by Allah Snorter Allah, bless his child-fucking soul, Muhammad is the model to behold. Muhammad, at 50, married his niece, Aisha, at 6, plunged his Allah bred cock into her when she was 9, had the courtesy to wait 3 years before fucking. Very nice, Muhammad, very nice. I love your sandy vagina. Since Allah said it, I now know that it is a fact that women are lower than me. I never liked women. Women are smell weird and they have vaginas. If I marry them, I get to rape them. Fuck women in the ass. Every time I read the Quran, the words just resonates with me, you know? If only the world listen to Allah's teachings more, it'll be a much better place. I can't believe some people misinterpret it and even say that Muhammad, trying to feel less guilty for his immoral acts, made all of this shit up, said that it was the words of Allah so as to validate his disgusting behavior. No. No, it can't be. Muhammad doesn't lie. Allah is real. My sky wizard is real. Islam is the truth. We created the heavens and the earth and all between them in 6 days. He who has made for you the earth like a carpet spread out. We created man from sounding clay, from mud molded into shape. If it ye can pass beyond the zones of the heavens and the earth, pass ye. Not without authority shall ye be able to pass. We once sent Noah to his people, and he tarried among them 1,000 years, less 50. One of the ants said, O ye ants, got into your habitations, lest Solomon and his host crush you underfoot without knowing. And of course, the famous story of Muhammad flying to heaven on his Burak, i.e. flying horse. But maybe miracles happen. Allah is so much more intelligent and so much more beyond us. When in the presence of Allah, science is bullshit. Allah is able to reconstitute
the very nature of the universe, redefine reality and shape it to his whim.
Or maybe Muhammad is a complete fraud and the Quran is fucking bullshit.
Both possibilities are equally valid.
Islam is the religion of peace. Torture.
The unbelievers' garments of fire shall be cut,
and there shall be poured over their heads boiling water,
whereby whatever is in their bowels and skin shall be dissolved, and they will be punished with hooked iron rod.
The woman
and the man guilty of adultery or fornication flog each of them with 100 stripes.
I will instill terror into the hearts of the unbelievers.
Smite ye above their necks, and smite all their fingertips off them.
Fairness.
The life for the life, and the eye for the eye, and the nose for the nose,
and the ear for the ear.
The unbelievers.
Then fight in the cause of Allah, and know that Allah heareth, and knoweth all things.
O Prophet, strive hard against the unbelievers and the hypocrites, and be unyielding to them, and their abode is hell, and evil is their destination. O Prophet, strive against the disbelievers and the hypocrites, and be stern with them.
Hell will be their home,
a hapless journey's end. There is more than 109 verses in the Quran telling Muslims to fight non-believers, otherwise Allah will send them to hell. I'm so confused. These more socially accepted, quote-unquote, moderate Muslims condemn the acts of ISIS, and yet this book says that you should be ISIS. So are these people Muslims or are they not Muslims? Do you try to follow Allah as much as possible? Are you able to knowingly disobey a few verses of the Quran and claim that you are a Muslim? If something in the Quran is not socially acceptable, does it mean that it is default that it is not the teachings of Allah, even when it is written in the Quran? How much of the Quran do I have to follow before I claim that I am a Muslim? What is life? What do you expect from the religion of piss? I mean peace! The religion of peace! La 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 la. Very nice ayahs in the Quran, very nice ayahs. I too have a verse for Allah that he will very like. My name is Jafar. I came from afar. I got a bomb in my car. Allahu Akbar. So remember, Muslims, having slaves is all right. The earth is flat. Women are definitely worse than men. People who are moderate Muslims, who don't kill other people, are underachievers. ISIS is good. And always try to make a trip to Mecca so that one day your vagina might just be as sandy as Muhammad's. Ha 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 ha. I am so going to be sent to jail for this.